This video will explain OWL's self-registration feature. Let's start with an example. Perhaps you have an employment screening activity built in the OWL test management system. You want to send your candidates an email with a link so that when they click the link, they will see this welcome screen and be guided through OWL's registration process. The self-registration feature can be used to set up new accounts, add to assignment rosters, and enroll users in classes. You can make your registration available to new users, existing users, or both, as shown here. When a new user clicks the Create button, they will see this registration form. This feature offers several benefits: automating account setup, validating email addresses, allowing users to create their own passwords, and linking assignments using OWL's flight path. Now I will log in as a system administrator and show you the steps for using this feature. Start by going to the testing menu and selecting self-registration. This is a two-step process. Step one is to set up the registration, who can use it, and what it will be used for. Step two is generating the codes. Here, you will create the links to share. We'll create a new code by clicking the Create button, and you can edit an existing code by clicking on this edit icon. This is the form for defining your registration. First, give your registration a name to help you find it in the OWL list pages. Then provide a description. This is the custom message that people see on the welcome screen. If you need to disable your registration code in the future, you can use this checkbox. Now, choose who is eligible to use the code: existing OWL users, new users, or both. This selection determines which of those two buttons the person sees on their welcome screen. Here you can determine if you want the activation to be automatic or require an email validation. Email activation is a good idea if you plan to send notifications. If you want to include an ID field for something like a student ID, click Show or Require to make that field part of the account setup form. Finally, we need to add some targets. Targets define what the registration will do. By default, you can add new users to your domain. Use this drop-down to indicate the roles. Then, click the Add button to give the registration a second target. We'll select our candidate screening assignment and select the role of student. Be sure to click Save, and then Done. And you will return to the registration list page. So that was step one, setting up the registration event. Now, let's look at step two, generating the actual codes. First, click on the control for viewing and creating codes next to the new registration in the list page. The buttons at the top are the controls. Select how many you want to create. Then, choose if they can be used one time or unlimited. And click Create. Now you will see a row in the table for each code. To look at any events, use this expand arrow. If you are just working with one code, you can simply select the link, right-click on it to copy, and paste it directly into your email. To disable an individual code, select it with a checkbox and click the Disable button. If you are working with several, you can click Export so that a spreadsheet file will be generated to download. When I close this code creator, I am returned to the registration list page. And that is how to use OWL self-registration feature. Thank you for your time and for choosing the OWL test management system.